And we worked on that question, does protein actually increase cancer risk? Mm-hmm. And so we, and for the biochemical point of view, I was really interested in what's going on inside the body and, you know, inside of cells and so forth. And I learned a lot about the relationship between diet and cancer, and then eventually diet and other diseases like heart disease or diabetes and so forth. It's all the same, mm-hmm. essentially. And it does involve the role of protein, especially protein from animal foods.
So a little bit expanding on that, Dr. Campbell, most people feel like they need to consume animal protein, animal products, in order to maintain their health and to get adequate nutrition. From your insights in your career, from all of those years of research, what is the association between animal protein and carcinogenicity? What is the takeaway message?
Well, the main thing is that the protein, first off, we get all the protein we need from plants.
We can get everything we need.
We don't need any more protein.
Just eating plants.
That's right. Plants have all the protein we need. In fact, plants can actually provide us really excessive amounts of protein. And this is something a lot of people don't realize. They think protein is only from animals. Plants have plenty of protein. And so in our research, protein, especially from animals, protein is an essential nutrient. We need a certain amount. But mm-hmm. when we go above that, especially by consuming animal foods, mm-hmm. when we go above that, that's when cancer may start to grow. That's when heart disease may get going and so forth. So is the protein going up. And when we do that in a practical sense, when we start putting more and more animal foods in our diet, you know, to get that protein, mm-hmm. it's an idea that people don't necessarily think about the science, but mm-hmm. they eat the animal foods supposedly to get enough protein. When they put that more protein in there, they're increasing the risk for all these diseases, not just because of the protein, mm-hmm. but also because as they do that, they displace the consumption of the foods that really matter. That's the plant-based foods. Plant foods is where all the health is.
Okay.
Animal foods, no.
No. What if somebody told you, what if I eat a lot of vegetables and fruits, but still eat some chicken, some fish? You still think
idea.
That the optimum idea is to eat whole foods, plant-based,
right.
vegan diet, so no animal products and no processed things.
The goal, mm-hmm. I like to say it this way, the goal is to just eat only plant-based foods, okay? For some people, that can mean saving their life, especially somebody who might be predisposed to get heart disease or something like that.
With all of the cancer insights that you have, all
that's
of the
right.
experiments. So
and we got cells in our body, all of us do, that could grow into cancer. And so mm-hmm. it's like weeds in a garden. You know, the mm-hmm. seeds may be there, they're not growing if you don't give it water and fertilizer and so forth. But
or they get destroyed, we probably have cancer cells every day that get
that's right.
destroyed by our immune system.
Exactly, mm-hmm. So when we're eating animal-based foods, mm-hmm. what we're doing, we're fertilizing, you know, those cancer cells. We're causing them to grow.
Okay.
And when we do that, we're not consuming the foods that actually prevent the growth. The plant-based foods, they prevent the growth.